All right, guys. So first thing I put on the hitting was our helicopter drill. So it's kind of when you think of a helicopter, you think of the helicopter, and then you have flying around, right? You have the outer, and it's flying around. That's what I want you to tell yourself. Your body is gonna move as a unit, and you are really gonna helicopter all the way around. You're gonna pivot those hands. Pivot your hip at the same time, and we're gonna work as a core unit. So, what the feel? What should be the feel? How do I know if I'm doing it right? What does it feel like? If you put your hands directly over your head and you got into your stance and you snapped as a unit and you snapped your core, you snapped your rear hip, and you snapped your hands, that's what it feels like. You can't push your hands forward and then snap. Just doesn't feel right. If you were to have a big, huge, I don't know, swivel or lid, when you turn that lid, you move your body as one unit. Your big muscles are incorporating and it's part of your swing. Your big muscles are doing the work, right? You're not gonna put the jar out here and just use your hand. You wouldn't have much power, right? So if I was gonna turn a wheel that was stuck, that was tight, I'm not gonna put my hands up here and turn the wheel, right? I'm not gonna get much power. I'm gonna use my body to turn that wheel, right? If it was stuck. We want that same idea. We want that same thought. We wanna use our core as one unit to snap. Snap. You have your hip pivot point, you have your hand, and all this is going to move as one big unit. So you're gonna start. And you're just gonna pivot above your head as one unit. One unit. Pivot behind your body, and you wanna turn that barrel behind. So I want you to do that 10 times, okay? 10 times, just feel. And then now try to create the same feel from below, right? Feel that. Feel it. I feel my back. I feel it really engaging my core. I feel me turning behind the body. I feel a corner. It really helps you feel what you need to feel like when you hit. Okay? We don't want our hands to push forward and then snap, right? These next 2 weeks is generating bat speed, generating quickness, generating hand speed. And the only way we can do that is generating max bat speed back here. And that's your pivot in your hand. So if you're looking at your blast and you see your blast scores, if you're not generating your at least half of your bat speed, so like let's say your bat speed is at 60, okay, you need to be at 30 right here. You gotta be at 30 bat speed by the time your bat gets right there. A lot of us, we can't get high bat speeds because we're at like 5, 10, 15, 20, and then we're trying to generate our bat speed at the end and it's too late. We have to generate our bat speed back here, and that's by creating that helicopter feel. We want the faster our bat is behind us, the faster it's going to be at contact. The longer you have to wait, the more sudden you can be, the better launch you're going to have. Okay? So, when you're doing this helicopter, really feel. Feel what it feels like to be a unit. Feel it behind. Think about we're trying to turn something and we got to use our entire body to turn that wheel that's stuck. All right, that's the helicopter drill.